'Cause I am tired and alone. Help me make it through the night, 'cause I don't like myself anymore. I guess I'm just not interesting. I have no personality. I met a guy with cancer, and he felt sorry for me. I've never been a social guy. I'm always making children cry. I guess that's just the way it's meant to be. Help me make it out of bed, 'cause I am scared and sad. Help me make it through the day, 'cause there's nothing out there for me anymore. 'Cause I'm always coming in last place and getting dirt kicked in my face, and everyone pushes ahead of me and no one stops to care. And I curse the gods each day in vain for giving me this life of pain, when all I really need's a little hug. Help me make it through the night, 'cause I am tired and alone. I don't like myself
Check, 1, 2. Check, testing the mic. Testing the mic, 1, 2. Test. Test, 1. Testing. Help. Help. Asparagus. Asparagus. Check, 1. Alexa, what's the weather?
Howdy, and good morning. The current weather is 75 degrees Fahrenheit with clear skies and sun. Throughout the day, you can expect more of the same, with a high of 83 degrees and a low of 60 degrees.
Hmm. Alexa, what's the difference between pressed meat and ground meat?
Here's something I found on the web. According to myfitnessbell.com, the main difference between the two is heat, at the roasting, or not, stage, and grinding, which involves heat, versus cold pressing.
Checking the mic. 1, 2. Test. Sibilance. Help. Testing. Hello, everybody, and welcome to Henry's Kitchen, where today we're going to be making Henry's famous Scotch egg. The Scotch egg I made famous in a YouTube video several years ago. We're going to be trying it today. I'm sorry I'm a little bit behind on some stuff. But I think we're going to be okay. I also want to say that today's broadcast, just like we did 2 weeks ago, this is phase two of the sponsored campaign for Factor 75. You can see the tracker up there with the special code that you can use to order boxes from the Henry's Kitchen channel, and you get a discount, and it lets them know that that you got it from Henry's Kitchen. And we're going to be talking more about that, but I want to say that this Twitch thing doesn't always come easy to me because there's a lot of technical stuff involved. Can you hear me? Actually, check. Purple donut filling as a fruit says I look very pale. Probably just stress. Also, I've had my oven running since we last did the stream, and that's making me feel a little weird for some reason. But What Da Duck says, do you think a day will come where space travel is common and we'll be able to eat eggs from Uranus? I think so. I mean, I've always been very optimistic when it comes to space travel type things. I hope you have your coffee. Coffee alleviates a lot of the stress that happens in the kitchen. I'm already feeling a little less stressed now that I've poured my cup. But I just want to say that cooking is difficult, and I'm going to do the best that I can to also do this sponsored segment. I think that it's best, usually, if you're going to try to do something difficult, to just let everybody know right in the beginning that you're not, it's not something that you're an expert at, and there might be mistakes, and you might fall flat on your face and screw up. But I think if you let people know ahead of time, that's going to take some of the edge off. Like if you're, I don't know, a cab driver, or if you're airline pilot or something, just say right off the bat, hey, listen, this is my first day doing this. I don't really know where everything is, and it's going to be a little rough, and I might not even succeed. But I think if you tell people that, then they feel better and more, it puts people in a more comfortable position. So let's talk a little bit about the Scotch egg. I'm going to be doing another recipe here from the Henry's Kitchen cookbook. You don't have to buy the cookbook. I'm not trying to promote it, but I will let you know that it is on Amazon. And, but if you, you know, get it, it's, you know, it's very expensive and very little of the money, goes to me on the cookbook. It's just, something that I wanted to put out there that people could have if they wanted to. So we're going to be doing the turkey Scotch egg. And this is going to make two Scotch eggs to be specific, and it's going to serve one person. It's going to be a pretty healthy dose. I mean, this is basically a hard-boiled egg surrounded by sausage and then deep fried and dipped into some kind of honey mustard or something. So it's a very high calorie dish, very high in protein, but very low in other essential nutrients. So this is not one that you're gonna wanna be eating. Okay, so the turkey Scotch egg, let's talk about it. Double-edged board says, if I'm mostly Irish and not Scottish, can I still make it, or is that illegal? I believe the Scotch egg is now accepted all throughout Great Britain. If you're in Britain, then please correct me if I'm wrong. Speaking of Britain, I want to do a quick check-in, a welfare check, if you will, on our my cat, Roast Beef, who's very old and sleeps most of the time. I like to poke him every now and then to make sure that he's still with us. Okay. Yeah, so Roast Beef is still with us, which is nice. A lot of people were concerned because there was a period of time when we were seeing him just sleeping for way too long of a period of time. Okay, so the turkey Scotch egg. There's a department store in London that claims to have invented this tasty snack all the way back in 1738, but turns out to be a load of shit. The real origin is that it is a bastardization of the Mughlai dish, Nargisa Kofta, or Narcissus meatballs. Narcissus was a hunter who fell in love with his own reflection. A reflection is a mirror image of an object which is identical but reversed. So Narcissus reportedly found the reverse image of himself appealing, and then he fell in love with it. But that was a very long time ago. Let's find out what all the fuss is about and make some Scotch eggs. There's a couple of irrelevant pieces of information in that intro, and I apologize for that. But let's start by gathering our ingredients, everybody. Okay. So what we have here is I've got some plastic wrap, which I have not opened, and I hope that that is okay. It's one of these organic types, which are not usually as good. But I've got three eggs. It's supposed to be four, but we're just gonna have to make do with three. I've got a work bowl. I've got some meat, ground meat, and I've got our breadcrumbs. The other thing that we're gonna need here is, and I just bought some fresh ones, some rosemary pricks. We'll put those there. And those are going to be a nice little sort of a, I don't know what you would say, like a seasoning or something. So those are our ingredients. Right off the bat, the first thing that we're going to want to do, I'm going to borrow the roast beef can here. And we're going to use it for our hard boiling our egg, which we're going to do now. As you can see, I have a hot plate here. We're going to put it on medium high. Push start. And this is filled with water. Actually, this is very hot. Fuck. So we're going to put... Let's go ahead and do that now. Let's put two eggs in there. And we're going to hard boil them. So... Alexa, let's go ahead and set the timer for 20 minutes.
20 minutes.
Okay. Double-edged board says hot water is dangerous. This is true. Crick 7612, nice technique. I assume you're talking about the hard-boiled eggs. Yes, hard-boiled eggs is an art all by itself. There's a couple of different methods. One of the methods is to put the hard-boiled, or to put the egg, the raw egg, in the water while everything's cold, and then it all cooks together once you start it. And that's actually the better way to do it, but I already had heated the water, so it was too late for me to do that. So this will be fine too. This is plan B, where you're just putting water, you're putting an egg in hot water. You can see what's happening now already. Okay, this is problematic. There's too much water in here and it's overflowing. So let me take care of that real quick. Guys, don't put too much water in your pot when you're trying to boil. You only need enough so that you're items are completely submerged. All right, so let's try that again. This thing actually only operates if there's something on it. It's called an induction something or other. But that should be going now. And if you get water in the electronic part, it can be very dangerous. So I'm actually kind of worried about that. But, let's go ahead and, Alexa, how much time is left on the timer? I'm going to turn the heat down on this. It's kind of a little bit too violent for my liking. I just want to have a pleasant Wednesday afternoon, and this thing's just popping and buzzing like crazy, and it's making me nervous. Everyone type force and says my eggs don't have a Scottish accent. Did I get the wrong ones? I assume you're talking, I assume that you're probably in Europe. That's my guess. I was not able to get eggs at my local supermarket, so I'm using some that I had a long time ago. And I don't think that eggs go bad per se, so I think I'm okay there. What was I talking about? Oh, okay. So let's, while we're boiling our eggs, let's take a look at some of the other stuff that we've got to do here. One, crack two eggs, pour into a large bowl, remove the shell bits as you go. This is going to be our egg wash. Beat it until it's done. Okay, so unfortunately, we only have one egg now left to work with. There's supposed to be more, but we're going to make do the best that we can. We're going to make an egg wash. And I probably won't even need the... I probably won't even need the work bowl for this. What we're going to be doing, where we're going with this, is that we're eventually going to be making a makeshift assembly line whereby we dip our Scotch egg into the various things. But let's see here. So we've got here an egg, so we're just going to crack it. Now we only have one to work with, so let's be very careful. And we're going to use the white and the yolk. Try not to get eggshell in there. That worked out. A little tiny bit there, but that's not going to hurt anybody. Okay. Now let's go ahead and beat it up. The rosemary pricks I actually got at the farmer's market. And I've always looked at it like the farmer's market is a little bit like going to jail. You know, where you just have to go there and kick somebody's ass right off the bat so that nobody thinks you're weak. Obviously, you're not doing it for real. You're doing it in a figurative sense. But my grandmother actually spent a little bit of time in jail. And that's tough. I'm not sure exactly what happened. I think there's a timed situation on my camera where it turns off automatically, so I apologize, but here. Okay, so this is a good time to look at some of your comments. Kira Slavia says, when are you gonna gamble on stream? I don't really gamble. Oh, I think I know what happened. I think I need to use a, I think I need to change the battery in my camera. Hold on. Sure what happened there. Let's take a look here. Well, we might have to borrow the roast beef cam so that you can see me cooking my eggs. You know, it wouldn't be cooking if there wasn't a bunch of shit going wrong. I don't know. Okay, so fortunately we have our other camera here that we're going to use. And Alexa, how much time is left?
You have 13 minutes left on the 20th.
Okay. Let's continue on here. Let's see. Udvol 14 says, is this recipe okay for a beginner like me to try, or should I just eat another can of SpaghettiOs? Yeah, now this is a little advanced, so I would say SpaghettiOs might be the way to go for this one, but you can certainly watch. I mean, this is a little bit like jumping ahead and you know, a math class or something, and coming in at the 10th class when they're talking about all kinds of shit that you don't know. It's progressive. You have to start from the beginning because we're doing all kinds of skills that we covered in the early days, you know, boiling eggs, breaking eggshells, stirring, whisking eggs, all that kind of stuff. But thanks for the comment anyway. But yeah, I would definitely do something that you're familiar with already. Can you hear me okay? Check. Test. Okay. Okay, well, I think these are pretty well beaten at this point. Let's start making our assembly line. Materials. I'm gonna consult with the book here for our next step. Sorry about the technical glitch here. I'm not sure exactly what happened. In a separate bowl, mix the meat with the cinnamon and the parsley. That's right, it's supposed to be parsley. Instead, I got rosemary pricks, but I think they're basically the same thing. And you're gonna knead it by hand until it's done. Lay out a piece of cellophane wrapper, flatten big meatball on top of it, place one hard boiled egg in center. Don't worry if runny, they will cook more when they're in the oven. Then pull sides of the wrapper. Okay, so this is a tricky thing. But we're gonna do the best that we can. I'm gonna switch cameras here. Well, oh, I'm sorry. I don't think I even had this thing on, which might have been part of the problem. Okay, here we go. That's what I meant to do. Let's get a piece of cellophane wrapper. If you're just joining us, we're making the turkey scotch egg, which is actually something called kofta nagisi. Alright. So, alright, in our work bowl, let's go ahead and add our meat along with some broken rosemary pricks. If you're following along and you've got your own ingredients, you should have in front of you a work bowl that contains a big glob of meat and some rosemary pricks. If you do not have that, you might want to try to think about what you might have done wrong. Okay, now I'm going to get a little bit of cinnamon. Cinnamon is sort of a, it's a little bit of a sweet spice, but in this case, it's sort of a secret ingredient, and it's going to make it nice and autumn-y. Cinnamon-y and delicious-y. So now let's go ahead and start kneading the meat here. So I'm trying to think of what we made last time. Oh, it was the spanakopita, or the spanakopita, depending on where you're from. And I made a bunch of it, and I put them out in little bowls covered with cellophane in front of my neighbor's doorsteps. But I didn't say who it was. I did it anonymously because I thought that might be, it might create intrigue, like maybe a little Santa Claus left some food in front of somebody's doorstep, and it might be exciting. But it actually caused a little bit of a kerfuffle. People thought it was some kind of vandalism, and some old people got scared. I think everybody's just reading news that's trying to fearmonger. And you can't even do traditional things. It's sad. Okay, so I don't know what that white stuff is, but so this is pretty well mixed at this point. We've got our cinnamon mixed with our rosemary pricks and our meat. So let's go ahead now, and I'm gonna grab a paper towel and we're gonna need to lay out our cellophane. I think I'm gonna put this across like this. There's not really any good way to cut the cellophane. So we're gonna take about half of our meat here. Try to get it in sort of a patty form. Put it out like this. And watch very carefully now. I'm gonna grab the sides of the cling wrap here and the corners. You see what I did there? And we're gonna make it all meat at the top, so it forms sort of a beautiful, like a flower looking arrangement. And then we're gonna tighten it from this end, and then we're gonna squeeze. Wait. I might have done something incorrectly there. Alexa, how much time left on the timer? Oh yeah, no, of course. I forgot, we have to wait for our hard-boiled eggs, and we're gonna put our hard-boiled egg in the middle of that patty, and then we're gonna do the process I was just showing. There was nothing in it, so. All right. Let's see how we're doing here with our hard-boiled egg situation. I'm gonna see if we can get a slightly broader camera angle here. Well, Alexa, how much time left?
You have 4 minutes, 30 seconds left. 10 minutes time.
4 minutes, okay, so maybe this would be a good time. Well, we could do a song. I had a request for a song. Maybe that would be a good way to kill the time here. You always have to do something in the kitchen that makes you able to pass the time while you're waiting, because there's a lot of downtime and there's a lot of waiting. By the way, make sure your ovens are preheated for this. I've got mine going and it's a little warmish. Let's do a request that we had from someone named Orase, and this was on the Discord. Orase wanted to hear this, sort of an uplifting song by a rockin' guitar player. So put on your rockin' shoes, because we're gonna rock out with this little number from Eric Clapton.
I saw you in heaven. Would it be the same if I saw you in heaven? I must be strong. Carry on, 'cause I know I don't belong here in heaven.
You're dancing.
Would you hold my hand if I saw you in heaven? Would you help me stand if I saw you in heaven? I'll find my way through the night and 'cause I know I can't stay here in heaven.
Alexa, how much time left on the timer? So that's a song by Eric Clapton that he wrote for his child, I believe, who had passed away. Orisay, thank you for the request there. And if you want to request a song suggestion, you can always go to the Discord and do that. But for now, let's continue with our Scotch egg situation. This is going to be a little tricky. What we need to do is we need to remove our eggs from our water. So in order to do that, I think I'm going to use some clampers. Rubber clampers, you gotta have these in your kitchen. If you don't have these in the kitchen, people are gonna wonder how committed you are to cooking. A couple questions here. That Russian guy says, can I also remove the water from my eggs? Yeah, there shouldn't be water inside the eggs. Alexa, stop. Meatbag 101 says, I learned cooking because of Henry, thanks. I appreciate that. Hacklin says, since I've always used the Starbucks internet living under the bridge because my mom kicked me out because I was watching your show, the Starbucks manager approached me and offered me money if I stopped driving away customers with my presence. I try to rent a shack and get on my feet again. Do you think I can make it? Yeah. Look, times are tough. I've definitely spent time sleeping in a Walmart parking lot with the doors locked, terrified that someone was going to come in and steal my car or whatever, but it was a piece of shit car, so it probably wasn't going to happen. But all right. But anyway, it sounds like Hacklin's dealing with some stuff, so I'm sorry to hear that. But we've got Scotch egg to make here, so let's go ahead and take a look at our situation. This is not going to be easy, I'm not going to lie. And this thing is really hot. There's a rubbery part underneath that's good. All right, so these are pretty well boiled, I would say, at this point, and we can finally be done with this concoction or whatever this thing is. And it even turned off this time, so that's good. Okay, so let's put our water. If you don't want to waste your water, you can use it for plants. But you can also just throw it away because it gets recycled, I believe. All right, so let's take a look at our next couple of steps here. Well, this part's a little bit of a pain in the ass. We have to peel these. And there's a lot of tricks. Unfortunately, I don't know any of them. So we're just gonna have to make do. But basically what you're doing is it's very hot, actually. Shit. So I'm going to put some water over this. We're going to chill that for a second. I'm going to go ahead and now, let's see, we'll let that chill. I'm going to try one more thing with this camera here and see if it works. I promise this will be the last time, otherwise I'll give it up. Yeah, I know, it just, I don't know why that's not working anymore. If there's any technical wizards out there. Pappy1 says, ice water, Henry, let it chill. Okay. How's roast beef doing? Roast beef is still basically in the same situation here. Yeah, while we're waiting for those to chill here, we can get a little shot. So as you can see, roast beef is still basically in sleeping mode. If you hit the camera, it should start working again. If you hit it, just hit it. Yeah, he did change positions. Did you crochet the blanket? I want to talk about the blanket. That's Linda Jed 8 said that. The blanket was given to me by a Twitch user named Sophia Salmasi, who's also become a friend, and she sent that wonderful blanket and made it for roast beef. And that was an incredibly nice thing to do. And he likes it. All right, we're still letting these chill a little bit. So what I'd like to do now is just make a quick mention. We're gonna be unboxing today our Factor 75 meal boxes that I'm very excited about. They came in the mail. We ordered them last time. And as you can see, cooking is a pain in the ass. I'm not gonna lie to you. It's just, you know, I've got hot plate here and there, all kinds of shit everywhere, and it's really difficult. Sometimes you just want to eat something quick and convenient. If you're doing fast food a lot, which is one way to do it, you're going to be eating unhealthy, you know. I a couple weeks ago was at a weak moment in my life, and I saw a commercial, I think, for McDonald's or something, and I just got in there and drove to it, and I felt awful. I don't want to put down them, but it's nice to do something quickly that actually is nutritious. So I want to say that that's one of the cool things, one of the many cool things about ordering these boxes from Factor 75. Factor 75, I'm going to say this because it's important. If you use my link or go to go.factor75.com and use code FACTORSE4324 to get $130 off across six boxes. There should be a link underneath the video. And again, we're going to be boxing it up later, but I wanted to just mention to everybody that indeed, it's a lot more convenient than cooking. And it's better food, it's more nutritious, and it's quicker. Okay, so let's go ahead now and see where we're at. I think we could probably start peeling these guys. They've come down to a reasonable temperature. There's a couple fancy tricks that I've learned. Does anybody have any tricks about how to peel a hard-boiled egg? I've seen videos where people do it like in one thing, but I don't know. All right, I'm just gonna go ahead and dive in here. I'm gonna crack it all the way around. It's still pretty damn hot, which is unfortunate. I'm not gonna make this process take too long because I can only imagine sitting there and watching a guy peel an egg for a half hour would be a little bit like watching paint dry or whatever, which isn't such a bad thing actually. There's a channel where they just 24/7 show people painting and you can watch it while it dries, and sometimes Roast Beef and I will watch that channel because it's relaxing. So I get it. But all right, so we're already almost halfway done with this egg. This is peeling nicely. And if you have a little bit of shell on your egg, that's okay. By the way, Okay, let's see here. There we go. So this is our egg, and what that's going to do is we're going to put that in the center there. So let's go ahead and do that part of the process now. Okay, so I might have just a little bit more meat. And again, we're going to clump it up, make sort of a patty. We need another piece of cellophane or whatever this is, cling wrap. And again, there's no easy way to deal with this shit because ideally you'd have scissors or something like that. I don't have mine right now. Nah, that was terrible. All right, I'm gonna get a much bigger piece. There we go. I actually do have scissors here, so might as well do it right. Okay, so now what we want to do is put this patty of ours onto our cellophane. It's supposed to be a patty, but whatever. And now we're going to put our egg in the middle, and we're going to do that process. And of course, it doesn't look like I have nearly enough meat to cover the whole thing. So I'm going to use a little more. Form it into ball form. You know what? We're just going to make one. I think we're just going to make one giant Scotch egg this time around. Because I didn't have enough meat to cover. So I'm going to get to your questions in a little bit. Right now, I'm very stressed out about how this is turning out, so I have to concentrate. Can you hear me okay? Check. Okay. There we go. So now we have here a ball. And we're going to do this to make it more firm. Okay, so now we've got a pretty decent sized ball there. I'm going to roll this out onto our plate. And you know what? I actually think that we probably could make two of these, but I'm not going to just yet. Let's get back into... You can always cut your egg in half for twice the Scotch eggs. That's purple donut filling is fruit. Cut the egg in half. Oh yeah, that's not a bad idea, but I'm sorry, I'm a little bit unprepared. I usually like to have a picture from the internet of what we're going for, but I think I should be able to pull that up pretty quick here if you just bear with me a second, because it's an important part to see what it is that you're going for. Let's see. Do you see me now? Okay. Okay. You hear me okay? Extraterrestrials says roast beef was live on your account last night leaking scandals about you, Henry. That's a terrifying thing to think about, but I hope that was misinformation. A lot of what you get on the internet is misinformation. All right, so let's take a look here at what we're going for today. This is our Scotch egg. Now, this is obviously photoshopped, and they've set up a whole session with trick photography and all that kind of stuff. But this is basically what we're looking at. And now it's time to get into ours. Which, so far so good, I would say. Now, the only thing that we need to do here is let's consult our book. It says here, pull the sides of the wrapper so that the turkey encloses the egg completely. We have done that. So that's all set. Now here we're gonna wanna open up an assembly line of sorts when working within our working station. We're gonna have three bowls. One bowl with the egg wash, which we have. We're gonna have one with the flour. I don't remember anything about flour. Yeah, we gotta have a third a cup of flour. And we're also going to have one with the breadcrumbs. So what we're going to do is we're going to roll our meat concoction ball into the egg until it's completely moist. Then we're going to roll it into flour until it's dry. And then we're going to cover it with the breadcrumbs. This is not easy stuff. Okay. I'm going to take a third of a cup of flour. And also, guys, I can't emphasize this enough. Try to have all of your ingredients prepared before you sit down in front of 1,000 people and start trying to teach them how to do something. It's probably just the big flour corporations. You'll do fine without it. That's Tanking Joe. No, I think we do need flour. I mean, a lot of times the ingredients that are added are indeed because of special interests funneling money into the culinary industry, but in this case we actually do need flour because we're going to be cooking it, and when you cook stuff, flour helps. All right, so I don't know if I'm going to use a third of a cup. I think I'm just going to kind of guesstimate. There we go. That looks like a third of a cup. All right, so let's make a nice assembly line here. By the way, Quanto, who is a technical advisor, says you could try switching the Canon source to something else. Oh yeah, that's actually a good idea. I'm gonna try that, everybody. We're gonna try one last thing to get the overhead camera to work. And then I promise I'll give up after that. Let's see here. I will say I've found that the viewers on Twitch are much more intelligent than the viewers on other social media platforms. And I'm not saying that to kiss your ass. I find it to be true. Everybody seems very technical savvy. So, all right. So we're going to go into this. This is the last thing that we're going to try, and then I'm going to assume that there's something wrong with my camera. Okay. Well, what do you know? There we go. We got it. It was just as simple as that. I want to say Quanto is a genius. If you ever need technical advice, hit up Quanto. I also just want to check and see if, yeah. All right, so we have our overhead camera. So we're going to go ahead now and make our assembly line. Quanto is also the person who did these wonderful transitions that I use in the beginning of the shows. And I'm messing them up, but here we go. All right, so we're gonna make a makeshift assembly line here. We're gonna have flour. No, first we're gonna start with our egg to wetten it. Then we're gonna dip it in the flour. And then we're gonna dip it in the egg crumbs. And then we should have, at that point, a complete Scotch egg situation, which is gonna be ready to go into the oven. So, here we go. I'm taking my Scotch egg here. And roll it into our egg wash. I'm kind of glad we didn't waste more eggs for this because I don't think we'll need them. There we go. You know, in Scotland, which I visited about 10 years ago, they have a saying that says that age is just a number. And that the higher that that number is, the closer you are to dying. And I thought about that a lot. Okay, this is unfortunately falling apart, and I don't know why. We're doing everything exactly according to the instructions, but you want to keep it sort of intact while you're doing everything. Okay, now we're going to dip it finally into our egg wash. No, not the egg wash. We want to put it in the breadcrumbs. Okay, now, fuck, man. Sorry for the language, everybody. This is not going easy. This looks like some kind of kitty litter or something. All right, I'm gonna bring this more into focal view here. I'm doing a lot of troubleshooting. Half of the things that you're doing in the kitchen are basically troubleshooting. And that's important to remember. But here what we have is a Scotch egg, basically. There's a little bit of egg poking out, which is unfortunate, but I don't know if there's anything that we can do about that. I'm going to wash my hands. And we're going to grab a cookie sheet. Got here a cookie sheet, which is really hot. I'm gonna use a tin foil over this because this is filthy. But here we go. We want to just place our Scotch egg on top of our cookie sheet. We've got that. And you know what I'm gonna do, guys? I'm just gonna make one more for you really quickly, just to show you how this works. I'm going to use the rest of our meat. Well, first I'm going to prepare my cellophane wrapper here. All right, and we're going to take the rest of our meat, flatten it into a patty, which I think might be the step that we forgot last time. Flatten it into a patty. We're gonna take our egg and put it in the center. And then now we want all the egg so that as much of it as possible is gonna be covered up. And we're gonna pull up the sides of the cellophane This is real cooking, guys. This is the real deal. Very difficult. We're gonna push it up like that into our cellophane wrapper, twist it into a ball form, and we should have a nice couple of balls. I'm gonna now go through this makeshift assembly line, if you will, whereby we have our egg wash. Next up, we've got our flour. Let's get this other shit out of there. Roll it in the flour. That might be one thing that we didn't do correctly last time. It's coming apart again. You can do all the directions exactly correctly according to the book, and it still does not cooperate. And I'm trying the best that I can to be patient with it, but it's not easy. Okay, and finally, we've got our breadcrumbs here. So let's go ahead and do that. This one's coming apart a little bit. I'm over it. Let's go ahead and put these in the oven. I'm gonna wash my hands of the whole situation. I hope everybody else's is going as well as mine are. Once again, sometimes it's good to keep your eyes on the prize, so to speak, and look at what we're trying to accomplish here. We've got basically a hard-boiled egg, which is surrounded with sausage or meat of some sort, and then covered in eggs and breadcrumbs. And now we're gonna put it in the oven, I think. Let's make sure. According to our book, I have to make sure I wash my hands before I use this book, because I'm actually gonna sell it to somebody. So next step, insert one popsicle stick in each ball and then place in the oven, which, by the way, should have been preheated at this point to 350 degrees. That I did. I actually did it to 400. Leave it in the oven for a very long time until the egg is cooked and the outside part is desired blackness. Serve with your favorite honey mustard or horseradish. Okay, so I do have some popsicle sticks. Although, I'm not gonna put them in the oven because I think that's dangerous. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna make the holes for them now so that they'll be there for us afterward. This one on the right might be a lost cause, but anyway, this one on the left is looking good. My left. Okay. Let's put these in the oven, guys. And we're gonna put this in the oven for about, 30 minutes and 400 degrees. And after that, we're gonna put our popsicle sticks in there, and then we're gonna enjoy the delicious Scotch egg. All right, so as you can see, I've made quite a huge mess of everything here. Alexa, set timer for 30 minutes.
30 minutes, starting now.
Clean up in the kitchen is very important, especially if you have company. I don't have any company, but I definitely have a big mess here. So What I like to do is take a paper towel and scoop it into another paper towel. It's just a method that my grandmother used to tell me about that she learned when she was in the joint. Okay, and let's do this. Now we are all ready for our exciting unboxing. Let me get rid of this other thing too. This thing's a pain in the ass. Alright. So this is my box that showed up in the mail from Factor 75. They're sponsoring the program today, so I'm going to tell you a little bit about it beforehand. As you can see, cooking by yourself is a huge mess, and when you're done with it, it's not very good either taste-wise or it's bad for you nutrition-wise. Wouldn't it be great if you could just, you know, you're sitting around watching TV and you're like, I'm hungry. Instead of having to do all this cooking and everything, you could just go into your fridge and pull out something and just put it in the microwave and eat it. Okay, so that's what this is. And I want to say a little bit of a technical situation here that I want to mention. And that's that underneath the video, you should have a link, and there's also a tracker here. If you want to get involved with Factor 75 delivering you meals every week, you can use my link or go to go.factor75.com and use code FACTORSE4324 to get $130 off across 6 boxes. So $130 off. I did the deal myself, and I'm pretty excited about it. Let's start taking a look at what we've got here. Let's see. I need some scissors, I guess. Pretty tight here. This is very exciting. It's a little bit like Christmas. I'm gonna try to get another camera angle here so you guys can see what exactly is happening. Alexa, how much time left on the timer?
You have 26 minutes left on your 30-minute timer.
Okay, so let's do... Okay, there's some nice ice packs here to keep everything cold. I think it's important to mention these are not frozen. These are fresh. They just need to be heated up. So there we have our chicken and mushroom marsala and our keto Monterey spinach chicken. More ice pack and a cold pack or whatever it is. Fiesta grilled chicken. You could tell I'm a big chicken guy. Peanut Buddha bowl. Oh yeah, this was something that was gonna be a little bit more into the healthy thing. Somebody, Addicted222 says, why is a cooking channel promoting pre-made food? I want to address that. You can cook if you want to. No one's stopping you. I'm not going to stop you. Your loved ones won't stop you if you decide, hey, I want to cook something. They might stop you if it smells nasty, or your neighbors sometimes, I've had neighbors call if I'm making something that's either smoky or smells nasty. But either way, that's all kind of a huge pain, and sometimes you just want to go to the refrigerator and just, you know, skip all of that and do something nutritious. And that's why it's good to have boxed meals sent to you. And hopefully that clears it up. We've got more boxes. Shredded chicken taco bowl. And our, finally, goat cheese and walnut bolognese fusilli. I want to say, I know I am a little bit of what you would call an expert in the kitchen or whatever, but I am not above eating other chefs' foods. And, you know, I mean, some of these, I might try to make them at some point in the future here on Henry's Kitchen because they look like they're pretty fancy. But these are all prepared by actual chefs who are good and know what they're doing. No prep, no mess. Factor cuts out stressful meal planning and extensive prepping, so meals come together in minutes, taking the guesswork out of what to make for breakfast, lunch, or dinner. Factor even offers meals for those looking to follow keto, low-calorie, vegan, vegetarian lifestyle. So pretty much whatever floats your boat when it comes to cooking, that's what you do. So I think I'm going to go ahead and start getting into cooking here. I'm going to pick the one that's called chicken and mushroom marsala. And I'm just going to need to get a plate. And again, if you want to get involved with the Factor 75 boxed meal plan, what you're going to do is use my link or go to factor75.com and use code FACTORSE4324 to get $135 across all boxes. So this is opening up rather easily. And I'm going to put this, we're going to need our other camera situation. Sorry, that was it's a painting that I got at the Goodwill, which is actually quite cool. Let's do. I'm trying to think of the best way that I can show you what I'm doing here. I've got these green beans. I'm sure most of you are familiar with the process of basically just putting your food in the microwave. But this is going to be chicken marsala. I'm going to cover it up with the sauce. And this is going to be a well-balanced and nutritious meal. And I'm going to eat it right now and I'm going to tell you how it tastes. But I will say it smells good. So let's go ahead and put this in there for 2 minutes. Oh. I want to make sure everybody's still with me here. Fortuna, Place it in the microwave for 25 minutes. I think, well, it's, I guess every one of these is different. This one just says 2 minutes. And actually, yeah, remove the outer packaging, pierce the plastic. Yeah, you don't even have to put it on a plate like I did. But, so it's even simpler. You could eat it right out of there. I just am sort of used to plating all my food, and I don't think that that's a problem either. But if you are going to just take it right out of the box, you want to poke that cellophane or whatever it is with a fork to vent, because otherwise, as with all microwaves, the pressure builds up and then you have yourself an explosion, and I've had that plenty of times. Microwave on high, 2 minutes. If needed, continue to heat in 30-second intervals until your desired temperature is reached. And we're gonna let it stand for 2 minutes, carefully remove film. So I'm excited. And you know, we've got our food cooking also, and that's gonna be exciting as well. But we've faced a lot of challenges today. We had a camera that wasn't working. But it's working now thanks to the technical advice of Quanto. Maybe this is a good time for me to, just sort of get everything ready for what we've got here. No, that's not quite there. Maybe I'll answer some questions. Addicted222 wants us to show the cat while we wait. He's not in that cool position anymore. He's under the sink and it's a little harder to get to. But it should be all right. But we have more song stuff, and I have other songs coming up that are not quite as sort of depressing as that one. Okay. So what we have here is our chicken marsala, and as you can see, let's see if I can get on here. As you can see, we did this in a very, very short amount of time. And I'm gonna enjoy it. We've got some healthy green beans. If you're looking to get healthy and you don't want the annoying problem of having to always get green beans and stuff, these boxes just come right to you and you literally just eat them. For some reason, all I have is a spoon. It's not ideal. This is very hot, by the way. I think that was enough time. I thought I grabbed a fork earlier. I think this is upside down anyway. Okay, well, while we're waiting to eat, I don't want to eat all of this because we've got our meal coming up that I want to eat also. I've said this in the past and I want to say it again. Always eat the food that you cook, no matter what. You've heard the expression, if you don't love yourself, no one else will ever love you. Well, it's very similar. If you don't eat the food that you're cooking, no one else will love you. X Diaper Baby X says, but I didn't cook this, Henry. Yeah, you're right. This is cheating. There's no doubt about it. But green beans aren't going to be so many calories that I'm going to not want to eat my turkey scotch egg afterward. So I'm getting some good fiber, some good nutrition. This is factor 75, guys. Afterward, you can look. All the nutritional information is contained here. 460 calories for this whole meal. If you're sitting around the house and you want to eat, you don't have to sit there and cook for an hour. And you don't have to go get fast food. I mean, actually, this is probably about as fast as you're ever going to have food. So, Phoenix 133 says, what's the sodium on this? 760 milligrams. So this one's got a pretty good amount of sodium, but I guess that's probably about average for a dinner. Hacklin says he doesn't have a microwave because he lives under a bridge. Can I eat it cold? Oh yeah, I'm sure you could. Remember, it's not frozen, it's fresh. You just want to have a little bit of heat it up a little bit. All right. Now let's get into the chicken. I'm gonna say it's delicious. I still like my own cooking, but it's kind of refreshing to not have to worry about it. This was ready in 2 minutes. All right, we've got a lot of work to do on our Scotch egg. I'm gonna have one more bite. And I'm not gonna belabor the point, but I do want to thank the folks at Factor 75 for coming to Henry's Kitchen and asking me to promote their product because it's good. I have 6 boxes of food here. I'm going to be cooking, I always do, and I'm always going to be teaching you how to cook, but there's going to be moments when I'm sitting on the couch and I just want to eat, and I'm just like, I don't want to climb Mount Everest right now and get in that kitchen and face the threat of violent knives in my body, or God, all kinds of terrible stuff, you know, fire, public humiliation. So many things can go wrong in the kitchen. This is literally just taking a box out of the fridge, heating it up for 2 minutes, and you're gonna devour it because it's pretty tasty. So once again, in order to do this, you can use my link or go to go.factor75.com and use code FACTORSE4324 to get $130 off across all 6 boxes. And the only other thing I'm going to say about it here is Factor meals arrive pre-prepared and ready to eat in 2 minutes or even less, faster than ordering in. Meal plans offer variety with rotating weekly menu of 27 plus meal options and 33 plus add-ons like smoothies, keto shakes, desserts, and more. All right, so there you have it. Factor 75. And I noticed that a lot of people did order from the Henry's Kitchen code, and I want to thank you for that. It tells the people at Twitch that people are ordering from the Henry's Kitchen channel, and also you save money. So one last time on that one. Use my link or go to go.factor75.com and use code FACTORSE4324 to get $130 off across 6 boxes. There you go. Alexa, how much time left? Okay, we have 11 minutes left. I think that's enough time to do a couple more songs here. We've got a request from someone named Ibrahim Ken Bakirsi. And by the way, the place to go to get these music suggestions in is the Discord channel, and the wonderful moderators are pretty good about posting the invite link to the Discord channel. That's where you can recommend recipe suggestions, you can request songs, you can show pictures of your food or your pets. Sorry. Right now, we're going to do a song that was requested by Ibrahim Ken Bakirsi. And it's a song that I used to hear a lot when I was a little kid, but I haven't heard it in a long time. So I'm going to assume that Ibrahim is probably an older person. But we're going to do the best that we can here. Everyone type force and says, Henry is the only person I've seen online that knows Brother Man Bill. Well, I didn't know Brother Man Bill except for it was requested several times on the Discord, and I think it's a pretty cool song. All right. Things we've gone through, though it's hurting me, now it's history. I've played all my cards, and that's what you've done too. Nothing more to say, no more ace to play. The winner takes it all, loser standing small beside the victory. That's her destiny. I was in your arms, thinking I'd belong there. I figured it made sense, building me a fence, building me a home, thinking I'd be strong there. But I was a fool, playing by the rules. The song goes out to Ibrahim. The gods may throw a dice, their minds as cold as ice, and someone way down here loses someone dear. The winner takes it all, loser has to fall. It's simple and it's plain. Why should I complain? The winner takes it all. Alexa, how much time left?
You have 6 minutes and 50 seconds left on your 30-minute timer.
Okay. So, Kira Slavius asks, I agree. Me and the voices in the walls sometimes just want to eat. Oh, okay. It wasn't really a question, more of a general statement. Delinquents asked, are any of these meals from Factor 75 for roast beef, or do you get them all for yourself? Yeah, they're all for me. Roast beef is a... Well, for one thing, I guess that he's so stuck in his ways, he's not really going to eat any other kind of food. And I was kind of pissed off because there's a lot of videos of cats and dogs eating ice cream, and it's very cute, and you get a lot of views. It might be kind of a cheap stunt to get a lot of views, but I can't even get him to eat ice cream. He just eats the same old shit every time. So he's a creature of habit, and it's hard to teach an old cat new tricks, as the saying goes. Monomate says you should give him the Scotch egg. Yeah, I could put it in front of him, but... it's like the old saying about you can lead a horse to water, you can lead a cat to a Scotch egg, but you can't make him drink. So we have another song here that was requested by someone named Saguaro_U. And this is another song from my childhood. So I gather there's a lot of people who... either these songs are still making the rounds and people are listening to them again. You guys hear me okay? Check. One. Okay. Thanks, everybody. Help. Yeah, I want to say that a good word when you're sound checking is to say help, because you get that P sound. You get the H, the huh. But you get that P sound, which sometimes can be too loud, so it's a good way to, it's a good barometer. If you ever get to a rock club or one of these places, you'll often see the singer of the band before they open the doors, get up on stage and just start screaming, "Help! Help!" And don't be alarmed. I mean, sometimes be alarmed, they might have a problem, but generally speaking, they're probably doing their sound check. All right, I better sing this loud because it sounds like we got a weed whacker coming in. Oh, boy. Jeremiah was a bullfrog, was a good friend of mine. I never understood a fucking word he said, but he helped him drink his wine. And he always had some mighty fine wine, singing joy to the world. All the boys and girls, joy to the fishes in the deep blue sea, joy to you and me. If I were the king of the world, I tell you what I'd do. I'd throw away the cars and the bars and the wars and make sweet love to you. Joy to the world, all the boys and girls. Joy to the fishes and the deep blue sea. Joy to you and me.
Alexa, how much time left?
You know I love the ladies, I love to have my fun. I'm a high flyer and a rainbow rider, a straight shooting son of a gun. A straight shooting son of a gun. Joy. So that song goes out to Saguaro underscore ooh, you. Wanted to hear that song, Joy to the World, by a band called Three Dog Night. Not sure what the lyrics are about exactly, but it definitely sounds more upbeat than the first song we did about a rock star grieving over the death of his passed away son. Kairosa says, hell yeah, nice rendition. Thanks. Thanks, Kairosa. And, Prince Kenny says, Henry, do you know a John Stafford?
Yep.
I know John Stafford all too well. Salix, you definitely practiced that one, pal. I did. It's a little bit easier, though, I gotta say, than some of these, ABBA ones. But I think we're very close to it being Scotch egg time. So let's start getting prepared for that. Once again, just to get us a little bit excited about what we're going to be doing here, we are going to be enjoying this goodness and putting it in our mouths and letting it digest in our bodies and eventually discarding the waste part. So I don't know. I think we could probably take it out now. I'm gonna have another sip of coffee, see if you guys have any other questions. I want to thank a lot of you guys are saying some very encouraging things. Oh, you know what? That's what I'm going to do right now. I'm going to thank the people who help on the show, starting with our moderators, Dingo Bop, Fawcan, Dom Beef, Hottest Bear, Do Dingle, Dogoggy, Dr. Flanges, Alexa Stop, Backhoose, and also other people who have come forward to help. Melon95, Pilskman, I want to thank Sir Doom for introducing me to the LGX and Bumble Vision and Daisy Blossom. And I'm going to say that on Thursday nights, I do a stream. That'll be tomorrow night in the late evening. So unfortunately, a lot of our European friends, it'll be about 4 a.m. But if you want to get up and watch, we do a stream that's mostly music and games and guests. So guest gamers. So we're going to play with Bumble Vision and the LGX, that are a couple of gamers that I've met in the community, and they actually have their own channels as well. And we're going to play a game called One-Armed Cook, which is, I've tried it a little bit, and it's extremely difficult. So that'll be fun. Oh, and Chase is going to join us also. So it'll be Bumble Vision, the LGX, and Chase. We're going to play One-Armed Cook, where every player has one arm and has to make food. And four of us will be two arms each, so that would be like two regular people. Not regular, but two armed people. I also want to say thank you to a lot of these pretty big streamers who have been spreading the word of Henry's Kitchen, starting with Nim. Nim's the one that got me on Twitch. He said, you got to have a channel. And so I set up a channel. So I owe everything to Nim. And but also a lot of these other people that have just randomly been showing YouTube videos from the Henry's Kitchen catalog, like Moon Moon and Forsen and Brian W. Foster and XQC. Thank you so much. And I know that there's more too. So, all right. Let's go ahead and take out now our Scotch egg and see what the hell we have to work with here. I feel like I need some prep for this. We're definitely going to use an oven mitt when we take it out of the oven. I don't want to burn my hand again. So, see here. Now we want to put our, of course, we want to put our popsicle sticks in there, and I'm trying to find what I did with them. I'm going to turn off the oven because it's very hot in here. Here we go. Now remember, we had some preset holes here, so that's going to make it easy to put our popsicle sticks in. And you know what, guys? I'm gonna say overall, those look pretty darn good. Let's go ahead and compare them to our, this is the Scotch egg. So it's a hard boiled egg surrounded by sausage. And then also some breadcrumbs on there. I think we came pretty close this time to what we were going for. And so we're gonna let those cool down a little bit. And meantime, I'm gonna see if you have any questions while we drink our coffee. Blurry Little Quest says, I don't have any popsicle sticks. Can I use pencils instead? Yeah, you could probably use anything made out of wood, I would imagine. Omega Fat Crab says, any update on the Twitch partner application? Yes, thanks for asking that. I submitted my application. I haven't heard back yet, but I've fulfilled the requirements, so I'm hoping to hear back. The promise that I made to everybody was that I would play some electric guitar once the once the partnership goes through. And so I've been practicing up and trying to get my old gear set up for that. So we'll be doing that for sure. It's very hot, and as I've said before, I always like to try to come up with something fun that we can do in the meantime. So why don't we continue a little bit of our game that we were doing last time? And it's a game called Stray, and it's based on my cat Roast Beef, Let's see here. Where we left off here, we have, I'll just explain, in case you're not familiar or you weren't watching, our cat, which is based on Roast Beef, who's a cat that that came into my hands, and I have no idea what his prior story is or whatever, but I like to think it's this. This is a cat that was hanging out with friends, stray, and eventually got separated from the group, and as we've seen, found himself in some post-apocalyptic world that's surrounded by robots, and there's these things called the Zerks, which are these creatures that eat everything, and they can kill the robots. The robots in this one are not very scary, like Terminator. They're actually scared of cats and of these Zerks. They're very timid. But anyway, Addicted 222 says, "All I did was call him bald." There might be another conversation going on there that I'm not familiar with. I am going bald if it was about me, but that's been the case for so many years now. I think it may have stopped, but I've heard all the jokes, you know. That's not a forehead, that's a five head. I've heard that one. But I do have a large head, which usually is associated with cranial magnitude. But my brain actually works very slow, as you can tell. So Jesse says, nothing wrong with being bald. Yeah, I don't really give a shit. RPB111, you should be wary of opening those factor boxes on stream. Black out your shipping label. Yeah. Yeah, and Quanto mentioned the same thing. I don't know if you can see it. If you do see it and you want to come over, I'll cook you some food. Anyway, let's go ahead, get into our game here. I want to make sure you can hear me okay. Do you hear me? Check. I'm not seeing any confirmation. Okay, someone says louder. Okay, so I'm gonna get louder. Check one. Oh no, check one. Oh yeah, and then let's make sure that you have audio coming from the game as well. There's always all this kind of stuff. You can hear the game now, I take it. You can hear the music. Good question about washing my hands. I'm not sure if I did, actually, but that's a good question. Okay, loud and clear. All right, so let's go ahead and see what Roast Beef is up to here in this post-apocalyptic world. So we have this musician, which is a robot with, it appears to be some kind of dreadlocks or something. And we've got some items here. We have a safe with a mysterious password, and what we're getting from people is, when we show it, it's an odd binary code that you have. Only a real geek can read this, but ironically everybody is sort of a geek in their own way, so I guess that they don't really know that they're being a geek. We have a poncho that we made for some reason. Nothing going on there. We have, I think, all the notebooks we're supposed to complete. Yeah, we've got 1 through 4 of notebooks. We have this energy speed drink that we're supposed to buy something there. And we have sheet music that if we give it to this guy, he'll play the song. This one was composed by a renowned algorithm. Hopefully it's not about his dead son. And then Roast Beef can sit here and chill and go to sleep. which is actually harder to do when a guy's playing computer guitar. But there we go. Let's get up. There's a lot of work to be done here. I'm not going to fall for the bag again. Oh, what the hell. All right, so he can put a bag on his head, but what it does is it reverses the controls. So this is roast beef, not the smartest guy. Eventually, hopefully, this will end. Okay, there we go. Enough nonsense. Enough chicanery. Let's get into some stuff. I'm going to go to this guy who's called the Barter Man. And somebody in the comments section said, "Can't find a Barter Man," which I thought was a pretty good reference to the Pearl Jam song there. This is a ancient relic, a testament to the talent of our ancestors. It'll cost you 3 energy drinks. I only have 1, so there might be more to be gotten there. What's, I guess that's all this guy's got for us here at this point. So, somewhere there's a directory we can translate. We've got Barter Man to the left, Super Spirit Laundry, where we already went and stole some laundry and were able to exchange that for the poncho or whatever. Grandma's Clothing we've done. Elliot Programming we haven't done. Elliot Programming is to the right. Let's go ahead and see what's there. Is it here? No. And if you guys have played this game, by all means, please tell me. I'll be checking in with the comments. There were a lot of really funny comments last time and that were cracking me up. Okay. Elliot Programming on the bottom there. Still this direction. Is it here? Elliot Programming. All right. Knock on the door and wait for us to open. I'm going to turn that off. This is how you do that. Okay, that guy's just standing there weirdly. We can translate. We were programmed to be slaves, but since 25448755556 days. Oh, okay. We have a soul. Hope one day the outsiders will find the exit of this hell, Momo. So there's a very Logan's Run-esque type plotline. Addicted222 says fake roast beef has a big ass head. Yeah, no, like owner, like pet, I guess is what that expression. Blurry Little Quest says roast beef needs some of that cranial magnitude. What's this guy all about here? You're here for Elliot. He's just over there. Well, yeah, I think that is the guy who we're here for. Check out some of this. Oh, looks like we got more sheet music to give to our dreadlocked robot guy. And let's jump on here and knock a bunch of shit over, which is basically sleeping and knocking shit over is the only 2 things that a cat does as they get older. Let's go upstairs here. I think this is the guy. Can I help you? Yeah. Let's see if he knows what this mysterious password thing is. You want me to read this binary code? Just a second, I need to calibrate my lenses. Here it means Duffer Bar. Strange, who gives rendezvous via binary code? Okay. Well, I guess there's that. That wasn't very helpful. But, you know, whatever. Oh, there's some other little things here. Remember. So if you're just joining us, this robot sits on Roast Beef's back, and he's looks like a jetpack, but unfortunately Roast Beef can't fly. This tree is a scientific marvel. It's remarkable that human ingenuity found a way to create plants that thrive without sunlight. Organic life requires trees to purify the city's air. Robots don't need it, but they take care of them anyway. It's what the humans would have wanted. So we get the feeling that there used to be humans here. What is Logan's Run? The domain GPCE, it says. It's an incredible sci-fi, I wouldn't even say movie. It was a book, but it was a movie, but it's become sort of a phenomenon. You could see that Roast Beef is sort of over trying to find the mysteries and stuff and just scratching the rug. It's boring. See if there's anything good to be pilfered out of this area here. Sorry about that, Elliot. But yeah, in Logan's Run, it was about a civilization where it was very efficient. They had blocked out the outside and all live inside a dome, and one guy wants to go out and eventually find... I guess I can change the music. That's kind of cool. All right, this place is boring. I think it's time to get out of here. Let's do some... Wait. I thought I'd be able to jump out the window, but I can't. I guess I could just knock this guy's shit over. Nah, we already talked to that guy. All right, well, I think that at this point we have all the notebooks. I think it's time to go back to Momo. Wait, we already did that, I think. Shit, does anybody remember what we were supposed to do now? I should have reviewed what we did last time. Is this guy gonna let me out? Yeah, thanks, buddy. You want something? Oh, okay. Yeah, I think I'm gonna talk to my robot because he probably remembers what we were supposed to do here. We found the four outsiders and the note on how to fix the transceiver. Let's bring it back to Momo. Under the orange neon. Yeah, that's right. That's what we're supposed to do. And I believe he lives up. The winner takes it all. All right. We need to find the orange sign, orange neon sign. I'm trying to get to a place where we have a nice aerial view of everything. Huh, I think I see an orange sign over there. So how are we gonna get there? Okay, I'm gonna... Addicted 222 says you got to take the tortilla chips out of the oven. No, I don't believe we have tortilla chips this time. Yeah, that's where we're going. Oh yeah, this guy sleeping. So we gotta get up there. Oh no, I'm going backwards now. Boy, they don't make it easy. Okay, there's this guy. Hey, little cat, you still looking for the notebooks? That's my notebook. Let's show him this one. Belongs to Doc. He was a huge nerd. He was always on the verge of a great discovery. That's Baltazar. Never quite understood what he was talking about. But he was wise. It's Momo. Clementine. Wait, you actually found all my friend's notebooks. What's this note? The transceiver can be repaired. This is incredible. That means we should be able to communicate outside of the slums. Clementine, Zabaltzar, Doc, I'm sorry I doubted your cause. I'll promise you I find a way to reach the surface. Thank you. We might be able to find you a way up. Now let's fix this piece of junk. All right. Vadi asked how the Scotch egg turned out. It actually is cooling down right now, and I'm very close to... oh, wait. This guy's fixed. I'm going to show it to you real quick here. Wait, no, that's... Oh, that's right. I turned off the camera. This is the Scotch egg, guys. It's a famous dish from Scotland. If you wanted to see what our original one looked like, it was something like that. But it's not bad, you know. It should be cool now. So we're just going to see what this guy Momo has to say about the situation. But thanks for joining us. Let's see. Tab. Oh, I think I'm supposed to push that. Okay, yeah. I'm supposed to follow this guy. Up there, see that building high above the others? If you install the transceiver at the very top of that tower, we should be able to communicate with the whole city. My friends might still be out there. If there's a way out, they'll know it. So now we have a transceiver that we have to install. You're the only one small and quick enough to evade the Zerks. We need you, little outsider. Bring us to the sky. Okay, so what's he talking about? That thing over there? Well, it looks like there's another one of these elevator things. I'll jump in here. Some guy's room. Oh, we're in the rooftops now. We're in a whole different part of the place. Press meow. Whoa, hey. Oh, shit. Oh, yeah, so these things are called Zerks. And we just got killed. Ah. Okay. You can retry it, but I think it's time to eat our Scotch egg. So let's go ahead and put this game away for now. Boom. Let's see here. Gonna quit that. All right, thanks for indulging me while I was playing a little bit of Stray, which has a lot of nostalgic value for me because I like to imagine that's what my cat Roast Beef was experiencing before we met. Let's see here. So Addicted222 says, why so many cat games, so little dog games? I don't know. All right, Gigasoy is right on it with how are the eggs? We are about to find out. These are the Scotch eggs. You can see they've got our nice popsicles. But before we do this, I want to mention one last time a very big thank you to the folks at Factor 75 for doing a whole campaign with me. And I want to let you know that if you want to get involved and you want to buy or get into the boxed meals, you can use my link or go to go.factor75.com and use code FACTORSE4324 to get $130 off across six boxes. As you can see, Factor helps you avoid fast food and ordering in with no-nonsense, delicious food that's ready quickly. Factor's chef-prepared meals take the guesswork out of eating well, so you never have to opt for something that isn't good for you. So that's another thing. You can decide ahead of time when you're not hungry which meals that you want to eat, and then you're not going to find yourself in a jam. So let's go ahead now and look at the food that we prepared here today, which is called the Scotch egg. And this is a very famous dish. Once again, I'm going to read from the intro for the Henry's Kitchen cookbook, just a little bit of the history. There's a department store in London that claims to have invented this tasty snack all the way back in 1738. But that turns out to be bullshit. The real origin is that it is a bastardization of the Mughlai dish, Nargisi Kofta, or Narcissus meatballs. But I think we're going to get some mustard here, which I have some somewhere. They never make these things so they work very well. You gotta shake them so much in order to get any of it out. Okay. I'd like this to keep intact. Yeah. That's nice. All right. This is called the Scotch egg. It's a delicacy that they eat in Scotland. It's where the term Scotch comes from. You've probably heard of Scotch tape, or you probably know people named Scott. This is where that originates. And we're gonna go ahead and take a nice bite into it. So far, so good. I'm going to try to get a little bit of egg in there. It's crumbling apart, unfortunately. Son of a bitch. But yeah, it's okay. It's a lot of work. Describe the taste. Well, picture a hard-boiled egg, but very, very hard-boiled. I wonder if 20 minutes in boiling water might have been too much. It seems to have lost a lot of the freshness and the flavor. And the meat is just overcooked, I guess. And I didn't really look at the directions to see how long it was supposed to be in there. I just kind of guesstimated. Most things are 400 degrees for 20 minutes. I think I went 30 minutes on this because we had some songs to do. Fat Honger says maybe the extra crispy one will be better. That could be. So Kairosa says, in a way, the crumbling apart of the Scotch egg is symbolic of life. Yeah. I'd say that's a good way to look at it. There's expressions, that's the way the cookie crumbles. Our Scotch egg literally just disintegrated in front of us. As a matter of fact, I'm going to eat the rest of it because, again, no one will love you unless you eat the food that you make. That's a paraphrase anyway. But I think I'm going to go back to my Factor 75 meal because it's a little more healthy and tastier. This is going to be lunch for today. This is going to wrap up the Factor 75 sponsored campaign. I want to thank them because I was ridiculously happy when I got contacted by a food company and to have them support the Henry's Kitchen channel. I've only been doing this a few months and it meant a lot to me. And I will not steer you wrong. This is great food. It's a great product. And I'm going to say one more time, there's a link under the video. If you want to get involved with Factor 75 and get these boxes delivered to you, you get a discount. And also, if you use that discount code, it lets people know that you ordered from Henry's Kitchen, and that helps. I don't want to go into too much detail, but the food that I make here is, it's not always delicious, and it takes a long time to make. And that's why having boxes delivered to you, that you could take one out of the fridge, cook it in 2 minutes, is a perfectly, there's no shame in that. So use my link or go to go.factor75.com and use code FACTORSE4324 to get $130 off across 6 boxes. There you have it, folks. Main 404 says, sounds like a fantastic product. I mean, it's good. And it's like, this is probably the first time I've eaten green beans in several years, probably since I was a kid, but I should have more because they're good for, they're good fiber. They keep you regular. Neon says, do you have a discount code for Factor? Yes, I'm glad you asked. Use my link or go to go.factor75.com and use code FACTORSE4324 to get $130 off across 6 boxes. Bullet point. Listen, I know I mentioned Quanto earlier for saving our ass when it came to the camera, but Quanto has become somebody who came forward and started helping with all kinds of technical stuff. Even the technical stuff with the subscribers here. So I want to say a shout out to Quanto. I think I might have missed saying that during my thank you. And I want to say thank you to some of these subscribers here. Vexules and Limpy and Beelzebub and Lexaman TW, Rezelling, Fuzzy Snugs, Al Caponage, Alex the Human, Nine, RGS Nas, No Bills, Jesse, Huge Milkies, Anti Vibe, Spookiest Cupcake, E Grazer, Husky Boyo, It was me, Contrabass Kazoo, J Moose, Niner, Kairosa, Fat Honger, and Bag XX, Ditch Match, Cheap Hardware, I Am Joey Grave, AJ Curdy, K3000, Moon, 2 Giga. Oh, I'm going into ones that we had before. So thanks, everybody. Also, Giga Mosher has subscribed, and Flaxident have also. So thank you, guys. Neon asks, do you have a discount code for Factor? Yes, I'm glad you asked that. Use my link or go to go.factor75.com and use code FACTORSE4324 to get $130 off across 6 boxes. I want to thank the people on the Discord for giving me some great song suggestions. There's some other ones too. I'm going to get to those for tomorrow night's stream, Thursday night. Again, we got Bumble Vision, we got the LGX, and Chase. You can... join us. We're going to play One Armed Cook, and just overall want to say a huge thank you to everybody, and also thanks to Factor 75. And Hamno MC says, do you have a discount code for that food box thing? You know, I do. It's actually on the screen as well, so you can use that. If you scroll back, you'll see that I've mentioned it a few times. The domain GPCE, what time does that stream start tomorrow? It starts at 9 p.m. Pacific. And Astro Wrath the Grim says, you're looking swole today. I don't know what swole is. If it means pale or sickly, it's probably because I've been under a lot of stress and not sleeping much. And I've had my oven on the whole time, which I don't think is good. I think there might be some detrimental effects to that. But Smisku says, what time is that in metric? I'm not sure, but I know it's 9 p.m. Pacific. Flamingo Dio Texi says, do you have any tips on poop consistency? Mine is fluid. Yes, there's something called psyllium husk that you can take every day that's going to keep you regular. And that goes for... if you have loose stools, like Flamingo does, or if you have constipation, either one. And you know what? I'm not ashamed to talk about these things. I've had irritable bowel syndrome for most of my life. I'm very public about it. I tell people, strangers, when I'm sitting there at the Jiffy Lube waiting for my car to be serviced, I'll just tell them that I haven't had what you would call a regular bowel movement, probably since somewhere around the Clinton administration. Hassan Crack says, women don't poop. Okay. But Kairosa, thanks for saying I'm brave. You know what? I'm not a hero or whatever. I'm just doing what I hope everybody else would do in that situation. So anyway, thanks everybody. Thanks for being wonderful, and I hope to see you on the Discord, and I hope to see you tomorrow night. I'm going to keep you posted on the whole partnership thing. I think that's going to happen very soon. I put in the application, and then I'm going to play some electric guitar as people requested. So let's take one final look at what we made today. The Scotch egg. And didn't come out necessarily as pretty as, you know, the one we were shooting for, but I'll tell you what, it's homemade and it's delicious and it's there to eat. So thanks everybody for joining me, and hope to see you on the next stream here at Henry's Kitchen.